Greetings. All right, thank you for joining us. It's the chat portion of the webinar. All right, the cats are here sleeping. Should sound earlier that it was in their minds. It's just like grounding. Okay, thank you for posting your questions. Carol, are any messages for me? I do see two spirit guides that are talking more with you about longevity in your future. Just leave it at that. You do connect to Archangel Michael a lot for living a longer life. Question two, are there any messages for my higher self? Yeah, it does make you are, you know, more safe and more protected than usual in the past. As you get older, it feels like you're also becoming more outgoing and talking to more people. You have to, you know, leave your knowledge, your energy with others. Pamela? Any messages for me? I just see Archangel Michael's energy. He's putting like a portal, a gateway around you to protect you from others and then causing you difficulties. A lot of that's been happening in the astral if you feel drained. But yeah, connected to, of course, nature, plants seem to be good. Rose garden is a good vibration. Any messages from Prime Creator? I saw like the lily pad energy connected to actually some of the Great Lakes, like in the United States, you're connected to. You also have a connection to the Mississippi River. Yeah, in some form, at least you've lived by the Mississippi in your past life. Gunyam, any messages from higher self? You're doing some soul forgiveness to heal your past, but also you're here to open up new directions, of course. It feels like there's a wall, but you're painting it so it can change color. I mean, a blockage that you're clearing currently. You're changing the color of the blockage so you can see more about yourself. Any messages from Nightfish? Being? I mean, there are fish. There's fish that have legs, and that's one of them. There's also fish beings that go to a bar and things like that. Like a fish reality, yeah, fish people. So, yeah, of course, that's like an astral memory, but either way, it is definitely a reality somewhere. Oh, let's see. Rachel? A few nights ago, we watched a creepy movie, Ouija Board, Origin of Evil. Oh, that's good. It felt like other beings watched me as I watched the movie. Yep. When the neck of the character started to hurt, the back of my left ear felt pain. Yeah, I would stay away from that stuff, especially if you don't know how to protect yourself. Yeah, because you can actually get an attachment from those movies. Did beings want from me, not just, yeah, to possess you. Yeah, because you're not aware of how to protect yourself. Yeah, yeah. I mean, you go to the movies, an actual being can come through the movie screen. Is there a message from what they want me to hear? I wouldn't want to talk. I mean, for some reason you want to talk to those beings. I don't know why you would want to. Yeah, other than I'm trying to possess you. I mean, I would, like I said, it's good to start protecting yourself better. I mean, if that's the world you want to go into, that's the world you want to go into. But that's entirely up to you. Anna? Any messages from my father who crossed in December? Oh, he seems to be doing okay. He's glad you had your baby. It seems like he's having a lot of fun. Does he miss his world? Not really, no. He misses some of the people, but he doesn't really miss the everyday grind. Question two, why did my son Marcus pick me for his parents? What were the warranty? I thought we already did that already. Looks like you already asked that at some point. Oh, he has an ancient Egyptian connections. But he picked each other. I mean, it's just he has a lot of Andromedan energies. Is there to... he's there to test you. Jeez. But, you know, you've been connected to him for a long time. You always knew you're going to have a child here, so... you know, he's an Anunnaki being, so are you. I mean, you're just showing that you can teach him a great deal and survive this world. You know, say, hey, be my kid and I'll get you through this world in one piece. Look at it that way. Yeah, so you'll help him learn the ropes. I don't think you're going to keep anything back from him or anything like that. I mean, obviously he's little, but, you know, when he gets older, you'll be telling the, you know, how the world works and everything. You'll probably be telling you what to do a lot, just to let you know. I bet you're going to love that. Amy, the other day, asked my angel Kitty for a sign that she is still around me. Last night, as I was laying in bed, I felt like a cat was rubbing against my feet. Maybe it started to tingle and healing energies. Was that my angel? Yeah, of course, definitely. Yep, and you can get more confirmations from the angels. I'm not sure how much confirmation they'll give you, but the kitty is definitely, because the kitty knew that you needed her around. But yeah, you can work with the angels to give you confirmations. And Angel K, yeah, message for me. Oh, she's around you off. I mean, she's around the higher astral. Yeah, she connects to you on a daily basis. It's just, you know, she lets you do your thing, live your life. Yeah, you don't need to focus too much on her. She wants you to focus you on your life and your abilities. Mikhail, can you tell me about my galactic self and what beings and races are connected to? I feel like they want to know more. Well, there's only so much I can answer here. I mean, it was a Andromeda connection. It feels like it's stronger. So I also have Arcturian energy. You basically used to floating around with no body. Of course, there's an Andromeda being. I mean, you have a light body. So, and you're... they say you're very good at games, like figuring things out, puzzles. Can you tell me more about my incarnation? This incarnation of your galactic self? Yeah, you came here to improve and upgrade yourself. You came here to better yourself. Yeah, this is school for the soul. So you came here to, you know, better your skills, your intuition, you gotta sharpen a lot of your abilities. And the way to do that is go through a lot of hardship. Donna, Fishstick made it to his new home. How's he doing? Is he upset that we sent him away? It is quiet here, West Cat. Yeah, cats, first of all, cats there love it. And Fishstick is just fun. I mean, he likes his name too. He's just a little weirdo. Yeah, it feels like, you know, he's definitely meant to be there. It's going to take him a while to adjust, because he did like tormenting the other cats. He does feel like he was put in prison, but, you know, he's a little bit mad, but he'll be all right. He, as long as he gets food and somebody cares about him, he doesn't care. He'll be quite fine. I think he does miss you, but don't feel like you need to bring him back. He's fine. He'll adjust. I mean, realize, astrally, they know about all this stuff. They're smart. He knew he was going to be moved out. You know, he knew that already before. That's why he was messing around a lot. Question two. So he was meant to be there. Question two. Monday was my second chemo treatment. Are you doing the job? I mean, they're doing everything their best ability. I mean, yeah, they're just doing everything they got. I don't know what to add to that. So, just say your prayers. Oh my God, it's Moses. Does my higher self have a message for me? Yeah, just don't sweat the small stuff, like bad investments and all that. You will create new funds to make things work out for you. So. Yeah, no worries there. Does my higher self have advice for upcoming months? I just see you investing in new like cryptos and things like that, but that's entirely up to you. But you'll do a better job at it, and you'll feel more profit coming through. But you just have to follow your heart, not your greed. Don't follow your mind, follow your heart. Your heart will lead you where it's the right place. Mia, do the fairies have any messages? The fairies you show, like, they move your, where you live. I don't know if you live in a house, but, like, to take your home and move it to the Agartha on a daily basis. So you seem to enjoy that. You do laugh a lot in Astral. You might not remember it here, but is there anything I can do to get closer to these fairies? Oh, we can get fairy tarot or fairy oracle cards. If you like, it's just another way of communicating with them. Or you can use like regular oracle cards or tarot cards to communicate with them. And of course, meditation. When you do meditation, just ask the fairies to show up. You can probably look on YouTube for a fairy guided fairy meditation and see what comes to mind. Miles, any messages from nature? Your energy is around a lot of earthquake places, especially in Chile. To make sure, is it an earthquake there? Any messages from my human consciousness? Previous lifetimes have been very materialistic. Feels like in this lifetime you're doing what's more important, which has been kind of a struggle, but you are seem to be accomplishing what you're here to accomplish. Mikhail, any messages from my cat Yuki? He's a bit standoffish. But he thinks he knows everything. He also thinks you don't pay enough attention to him. So he's just an attention hog, basically. So, yeah, just, yeah, finicky and all that, but. Seems like he sees a lot of ghosts. So, yeah, just do whatever you need to do around him. Yeah. If you need, yeah, pay attention to him. If he gets finicky and runs off, you did your job. Things have not gone well for me at work. Any messages? Oh, I'll pass. Next month will be better this month. Yeah, it has to do with I don't know if we're in a retrograde, but it feels like we are in one. Yeah, just stay calm through. Oh, settle down. Gerard, am I allowed to have any insight into why in my current situation, maybe how to get out of it? Well, first off, I don't know what the current situation is. Yeah, it's hard to help you out of it when I don't know what it is. There's only so much I can tap into here. These are just chat questions. This isn't like seeing through your whole life, but I can give you a general connection. Why am I in my current karma is the way you're in that situation? How to get out of it is to use self-forgiveness and be honest to others that are around you. It's definitely a karma. And so karma doesn't mean that you're bad. It just means you have a karmic connection with those people. You feel those other people involved. I don't know what that is. Nan crossed over a week ago. Family isn't doing too well. I don't know who that is. That's who. How is she doing? Any messages? First of all, I don't know who it crossed over because I don't think it was typed up right. But that's okay. It seems like she's doing fine. Of course, I'm only tapping into the best I can at this point. She just says, Yeah, just, they have to grieve. So either way, she warned, she told them, at least in her words, she put the message out there. She was on her mail. She knew. And she didn't like bluntly say it, but there's part of her that was kind of hinting at it, even if she, I mean, not consciously. It was like unconsciously she was doing that. So, any messages? I think that was all there is. Just send her love, basically. Vasco, who has been around me lately? Do any messages? Archangel Michael. Stuff to help you calm your energies down and focus on what's right for you. Any messages from my higher self? There is a new direction that'll open up. That would be make that would eventually give some more reason to why certain events occurred. So you don't know over time. So right now, just the best you can to heal at this point. Heal. Last week, my guides told me I was on the right track. I really felt a little disoriented. So, can my guides specifically, what exactly they mean by right track? Well, if you're on the wrong track, you'll be, have to reincarnate again. Mean, you're doing everything in your power to do what's best for you. That's the right track. You're not going to fail this life. Let's put it that way. Yeah. So, some people think that the tunnel of light that people go through after they die is a fact of any. It's yeah, soul trap. Yep, and they're correct. Yeah, don't go in any tunnel. Just when you just cross over, you'll know. First off, the angels will let you know, and you'll be fine. You just like go to sleep and wake up somewhere else. Look at it that way. But that's an easy version of that. Lesh, what was I doing in my incarnation as a Draconian reptilian? Take, well, you really want to know? Well, yeah, taking over cities, taking over worlds, enslaving some races. I mean, you didn't do it alone, you were with others. So you came here to remember. And share your knowledge, whatever comes to mind. Right now, just do what you need to do. What message do my angels have for me? Self-forgiveness is happening. It seems like there's a lot of regret with you. It's not, yeah. At least somewhere in your soul it's there. It seems pretty deep. Jess, what message inside does Archangel Anastasia have for me at this time? Just keep your looks up. I mean, you asked. Yeah, keep your looks up because it seems like it helps your vibration. And let's see, you have a roommate. I feel like you're connecting to your roommates and heal that energy eventually. What's going on? I feel like you're on the right track to do so, but hasn't fully activated just yet. Well, you know when the right time is to heal that, let's put it that way. What message is my guide, is my higher self have for me today? Just don't overcomplicate anything. Not that you do, but sometimes you can have a tendency to do that time to time. So just concentrate on what you feel is right. Okay. All right. Thank you, everyone, for posting your questions. Great blessings.